welcome everyone here today to our seminar on taking your career to the next level and how to become a smart bear. So I'll kick off this afternoon first with a very brief company introduction, a bit about our culture, and then we have some guys here who will speak about the specific roles that we have available as they do vary from one another. So on the next slide there, please, Kieran. So here we have a bit about SmartBear. So we are the leader in software quality tools for teams. So behind every piece of software, there's a very, very good software development team. And we develop tools to ensure the quality and help that team deliver the best possible quality at the quickest pace that they can and ship that code out as quick as they can. So I will go into some numbers just in a second, but there's over 6 million developers, testers, and operation teams using SmartBear products in 22,000 companies at the moment. Our products are used now in about 194 countries, and our software is downloaded almost every second. So it's less than every 4 seconds at the moment. So we're also upping that a bit at the moment too. So just the next slide, please. So here's a bit about our numbers. We currently have 16 products. There's 6.5 million users of our products in 22,000 companies. As I said, a trial is downloaded every couple of seconds, getting into the less than 4. And there's just over 350 employees across our 7 locations that we have. So on the next slide here, you'll see a small map. So here in Galway, we have our EMEA headquarters. We have our main headquarters over in Boston. We have an office in Memphis, in Coconut Creek in Florida. We have Tula in Russia. We have Stockholm in Sweden, Melbourne, Australia, which is the newest one, and soon to be Bangalore in India, which is opening in the next couple of months as well. So a very busy time for us here at SmartBear, and we're really, really in a high growth period, which is great to see, and lots of expansions there. Personally, I work in the EMEA headquarters here in Galway, and I actually touch base with almost every one of these teams on a daily and weekly basis as well, so we're super, super connected. So just the next slide, please. So here's a bit about our EMEA headquarters here in Galway. We're right in the middle of Galway City, so we're literally just down from Air Square. We have a really, really great company culture. I am on board just over a month now at this stage, and I feel like I'm part of the family. So once you walk through the doors, it's a really good, energetic, great vibe from the company, lots going on there as well, really comfortable environment. So it's a very good work-life balance. We have a bear cave there with all our bits and pieces in it that you can have ping pong matches, golf, video games, great kitchen, and they keep feeding us when we get in there as well, so it's brilliant. And also you have that nice little balance when you go in there too. So before I hand you over to the guys to talk about the specific roles, here's just an overview of what we have. So we have a couple of sales roles, SDRs, so sales development representatives, account executives, associates, sales engineers as well. Kieran's going to speak to you about the development side of it. So there's front-end development, junior, mid-level, Java development, customer success. So we have a role available for a customer success manager, and then also some Java development there as well. As I said, these people will get into them now in a couple of minutes. So I think it's over. We'll move one more slide away, see. And just before I hand you over to Kieran, if you do want any more information, please just go onto our website, smartbear.com/careers. They're all listed there. And also you'll have your opportunity to upload your CV. Have a look and see which one will suit you best. Have a look at a couple of our videos there. You'll see some about our Galway office, our Boston headquarters, everything like that. So you'll be able to get a feel for the company on that page as well and have a look around. So I'm gonna hand you over to Kieran for the next piece
of the deck, and I'll switch sides with you. I'll get you. Do you want me to get it?
Is the website on the pamphlet, right?
Yeah.
Alright,
so you don't
have to remember that website. You can grab the pamphlet up here where you can submit resumes and stuff. Yep, okay.
So great to see some of you. I talked to some of you earlier on, so thanks for coming down. One of the areas that we talked about, I talked with some people about earlier, is around the API space, which is one of the key areas that we in Galway are interested in, but more generally as a company. And so when we talk about APIs, for anyone who isn't too au fait with it, is that APIs we use to, I guess, control how two different systems talk to each other, what the information is that they pass between them, communicate back and forth, and I guess how you build products and how you build companies around that. And so that might sound a bit woolly for some people. So a good example is I guess any kind of app that you have on your phone, there's an app part of it that a developer has gone and built that works on your Android device or your iPhone device, but it talks to a server or a system somewhere. So email is a great example. Right? So anyone who registered today, they got an email from Job Expo to your service provider, your email service provider, and that email made its way from that server onto your desktop or your handheld device, or you logged into a web page somewhere, pull that information out. They all talk to each other through APIs. And in that case, your Google, your Gmail, or your Yahoo, or your Outlook, they all provide a set of APIs that tools are built around. More specifically, because that one has been around for quite a while, more specifically, you see lots of companies out there that build APIs and share them out so that they can make more of their business available to others. So we see it in retail, we see it in fast food, so the likes of your pizza providers, your McDonald's do it, reservation systems like hotels and airlines, they all build APIs, firstly for themselves, but then more and more increasingly for others to use. So they'll partner with other companies. And that's what this graph is talking about. So the number of APIs that are out there that are available for people has grown significantly over the last couple of years. And this is from last year, so it's only going one way. And they're the ones that are public. They're the ones that we know about. But we know that there's a large percentage of APIs that are for private consumption that organizations build themselves. And so for us, the important bit is right here. So we see that most companies will have APIs that they will build themselves, whether they're for internal use or not. Right? And so why is that important to us? Well, it just so happens we've got a product that addresses a lot of this. We've got a couple of products, but so some of you may be familiar with Swagger. So Swagger is an open source platform and tool that allows you to define APIs. It's been in existence for a couple of years. It is all open source, and SmartBear contribute to the open source and define the life cycle of Swagger. We've just recently released version 3 of it, which is exciting for anyone on the dev side because it gives you a lot more capability. Here specifically in Galway, we have a development team that deliver Swagger Home. So it's the commercial version of Swagger. It's an online platform that allows people to develop and build out APIs and collaborate on those across different teams in different locations. All of the development for that product is done here in Galway, in the location that we just talked about. Right? And so for anyone with a tech hat on, it supports your full life cycle. So how you design APIs, how you release them, how you test them, how you monitor them. It's a pretty big deal for us. We've invested quite heavily in it. We've built a team here to do it. And we can see that there's interest in the future. The market is there from what we can see. So I guess the question then is, how are we doing? So the next slide is, I guess, particularly around Swagger Home. How are the numbers standing? So it's quite actively used, quite a large user base that are actively building and contributing to it. It is tools that are for developers, built by developers. So you know, we do have a good sampling. We do encourage our own teams to use our own tools as well. And we've got a sampling of, I guess, some of our better known brands out there. They're growing all the time. And because it's 24/7, people are using it on an ongoing basis. So that's the product, right? That's what we build here in Galway. Right? It's been a journey to get to where we are. We set up an R&D center about 9 months ago here in Galway. And we've since then taken ownership of developing this product, building it out, addressing the needs of our customers. through hiring of a balance of senior and junior people. Our plans for the future is that we'll continue to scale and continue to grow, but we're going to do it in a way where we have a mix of senior people who bring experience and more junior people who can bring that balance to it, so that they can complement each other, right? And build out a team that is more collaborative with a pretty flat organization structure behind it. So some of our positions that we posted are mid-level, some of them are junior. We've also just finished a really successful internship program for the summer, where we engaged with the third level institutes and brought some interns through for summer work for the for 3 months. And at the end of it, we managed to retain the services of one of those, who's now a full-time employee. So we try and address quite a broad spectrum of people and abilities, and look to harness and to nurture that through over the 3 months, but also for the longer period. Okay, so next slide are the positions themselves. And so the way that we look at it is in terms of, because APIs is our space, that's the way we work, we clearly define roles around that. So we have front-end developers and back-end developers, and the way that they work together is through an API. So we use our own product, we use Swagger to define how front-end and back-end guys work together. On the front-end side, we look for pretty new and contemporary tools that are out there. So it is JavaScript, we look for frameworks of any description. Ideally, we look for React or Angular, for people who have experience in single page application, either at a junior level or at a mid level, then it's something that we'd be interested in talking to. We do, as I said, we have a balance in there, so we know that no one knows all of it, but hopefully as a team, based on the experiences that we have, that we can build it out for the future. And the same is true for the back end, where we are looking for mid-level and junior Java developers. So this would be, we very much have embraced the microservices architecture. So we componentize and Dockerize all of our microservices, and we deploy them into a cloud-based solution called AWS. So anyone who has experience in that or full stack Java, so databases and raw Java, certainly a conversation that we can have as well. Okay, so I've thrown a lot of stuff out there. Hopefully some of it stuck. I think we'll do a Q&A at the end.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. So any questions, I'll be back if anyone wants to ask anything. We're here for the day as well, so if anyone wants to come and talk through specifically, we have job descriptions that are at our booth, and we do have a page with our job listings, the current ones, and it is actively updated. So if anyone wants to keep an eye on that or wants to talk in any further detail, then please do come visit. Thanks.
Can everybody hear me? I hate using microphones, it's the sound of my voice over a speaker. But anyways, as I said, my name is Mark Bagby. I've been with Smart Bear for 5 years, just over 5 years. Living in Galway for about 9 months now. And we have, thanks to people like Kieran and Kira, we have very strong engine of inbound interest in our products, so we are the benefactors of that. So obviously that comes as a result of 16 great products, great marketing people, obviously great product people, and great people in HR as well. I think we can go to the next slide. Yeah. So we have three open roles in the sales department. One is for sales development representative. Some other people might know them as business development representatives. This is basically frontline sales. It involves a lot of prospecting, so calling, emailing net new customers or new, I guess, prospects within existing customer bases. As I said, we have 16 products, so there's a lot that we could always be talking to our customers about, so we are very lucky. next slide. The account executive role, this is for the API business, so we sell products that Kira and his team build, and we also sell some other API products. So OpenUI is the flagship, and it's a functional testing tool for APIs and web services. Account executives, they are basically responsible for finding net new business. This could be new brands, like new logos, or they could also be new divisions with an existing customer brand. So for example, we have a customer, Thomson Reuters, I think it's risk management or risk assessment. And but we don't have Thomson Reuters legal, so we can sell it to them. That would be a net new business entity, right? So it's high velocity, you know, probably, you know, I'd say on a given week, these guys are getting 100 probably inbound leads that come in the form of a trial download or, you know, content download, for example, like an ebook or white paper, etc. Go on to the next one. Associate sales leader.
I'm just gonna give you a hand on that one.
Yeah. Sandra.
My name is Sandra. I'm working as a HR generalist with SmartFare. I've been with them now for a year and a half. I came from a completely different background, so I came from medical sales, and when I joined SmartFare, I was given the opportunity to literally completely change my career path, to try something new. I've been supported and helped to develop a completely new role, and I'm going on to do a course to kind of help with me in that role. So in terms of support and help to candidates, they are absolutely fantastic. So we do have a couple of other roles on top of the sales. One is the associate sales engineer role, and that's basically where you're giving technical support to companies. So companies that are using our products, that they have issues, they ring the technical support team, and as a sales engineer, you're able to give advice and develop a bit of a relationship with that company. And you're there at the other end to help them to use the tools that they have to their full advantage. And then we also, you've heard a bit about what Kieran said and about the products that we do and about the sales, and they really are incredible products. So you can imagine how rewarding it would be to be part of the strategic customer success team. And in the States at the moment, that team is getting bigger and bigger, and now they're moving it into Ireland to develop that more in Ireland. So what happens is you develop relationships with customers, you become their partner as such. So you're making sure that they're happy in the products that they're using. If there's new products that you think that they should be using that will help to develop their business, you can help them to do that. So you're developing relationships with elite customers, and you're becoming their trusted friend and advisor. So it's a really, really rewarding job because the products are fantastic and the customers are generally very, very happy. So that is, we are actively working on that role at the moment, and we're actually interviewing the week after next. So it's one that if it's something that interests you, take a look at it on our website and you can apply through the website. But at the moment we're upstairs for another 3 hours. So if you want to come up and have another chat about it, that's absolutely fine. Again, that's just our website. We'd really like to thank everybody for being here. It's been great meeting you. So we'll hand you back to Kira.
Perfect. So I think we're going to open the floor to some Q&A, and we'll get all the guys up here. I am the marketing manager for EMEA, ANZ, and soon to be NDA as well. So I'll handle any of those things. We have Mark here in sales, Kieran development, and Sandra, who is a generalist of everything that's going on as well, so she'll be able to give us a hand out with all the roles too. So I think we have 1 minute left for questions, but if, again, we're all going straight back up to the booth afterwards as well, so please do stop by. We have all the roles laid out with the information you need on it, and again, we can direct you to our website. So if anyone has any questions?
Any example of other products, you know, except soccer?
Are there other products?
We are developing tools for companies to analyze for analytics and statistics.
It's for essentially testing and building software.
And monitoring software. So we may support the analytics by driving traffic through. right? So that the data is generated so that they can own their own vision, so we can monitor the services to make sure they're available for our applications.
SoapUI, have you heard of SoapUI? That's kind of a flagship product.
Actually, I was wondering what exactly is SoapUI.
SoapUI is an automated functional testing tool for EBIs and services. Yeah, so really popular. I mean, that product is, I mean, how big is that going to be? I think it's almost as big as Swaggers.
Yeah. It's very actively used. It's a huge open source product. It's been around for a while, as the name would suggest, because it now supports other things than originally, but quite actively used.
Great, any more questions? No? Okay, I think we might leave it at that. Again, we're just straight on our way back up to the booth. Please do stop by. We have more information and we can chat to you about the roles as well. Thank you everyone for attending.